Anyway, look, very pleased to say the manager of PES United. So, it's the purists call it PES United, some call it PES United, but, you know, it just depends on which side of the tracks you're from. Manager Bilal Zafar joins us. Bilal, how are you doing?
Oh, fantastic. How's it going, lads? Yeah, good to hear from you.
Really good. Now, some of our listeners won't have been following your season too closely. Just remind us how it's been going and what division you're in and those sort of basic questions.
It's pretty good. We're promoted to the top English division now. Got European football, not the top European competition. It's the UEFA Cup, the just below. You know, I would have preferred if we played all our games in England, but we have to go over to places like Spain. And we've started all right. Lost one game, 1-2.
Great stuff. Now, just so people know that you're playing on, it's Pro Evolution Soccer from 2005. And you have a broadcast rights with Twitch, is that right?
Yeah, it's twitch.tv/Zafarcakes, Z-A-F-A-R-Cakes. Yeah. It's weird, it's a broadcast.
And so it must be nice to be playing in 2005 when everyone's available.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Best time of football.
I don't want to sort of talking about money is also quite awkward sometimes, Bilal. But did they bid a lot of money for the rights to this?
They bid quite a lot. I mean, the problem is you talk to the club accountant. I don't really understand a lot of these things. I'm just a good family man. I'm a football man. I don't really understand all these things. Apparently, it's only been about we were talking to some of the big BT Sports, Sky Sports, and then Twitch came in. Apparently, it's £30 a month we're getting, which. I mean, that's not enough to buy a cone.
No, it's not great.
I'd say it is enough to buy a cone.
How much is a cone?
I don't know, Bilal might know. Maybe his coach
knows the price of cones, Bilal.
Oh, it's about 40 quid a cone these days.
Oh, wow. So, yeah. That's extraordinary. What would you say your playing style is, Bilal?
We kick it long. Sometimes we kick it sideways. We try and run as fast as we can pretty much all game. We're trying to, sometimes we cross it, but not... Sometimes the crosses go too far and then you just kicked it out of play and that's not ideal. So really we're trying to just get it in the goal as best we can, as quick as we can.
Okay. Has there been an issue with, that sort of continual high press, sort of burnout for some of your squad? Because even if you look at, say, Liverpool, and I know it's a different type of football, but the high press, they press at the right time and they don't necessarily run as fast as they can for the entire football match.
Yeah, I don't really, sorry for saying this, but I don't really like that kind of style, a lot of passing and stuff. I mean, I don't really feel like it's English. We're okay, though, to be honest. I mean, look, we train look, every Wednesday on training. It's run as fast as you can.
Right.
For as long as you can?
For as long as you can. Okay. Run as fast for as long as you can. Thursdays, it's cone work, just try not to step on the cones.
Mm-hmm. Who's of your squad, who can run the fastest for the longest?
Castolo's a good lad, Brazilian foreign lad. We've got Dodo, Italian foreign lad. He's one of the hardest men in football. I guess his job to run around, really. I'd say he's the best.
Okay. And now, earlier in the season, one of your players had to go off, what with it being 2005, had to go off to serve for his country in the army. Was that right?
Yeah, Jarasic. I mean, these are the things that happen, You never know. Because the thing is, you guys know, you're good football family men. Football is as football does, as you know. And one day, we just got an email saying he had to go off to war. It was actually just a badge in the end. Right. But, it's made him a better player. He doesn't really talk anymore, but a fantastic player now.
Paul in Mitcham has been in touch to say, 40 quid for a cone. Is that with or without the flake, he asks.
Nice joke from Paul there.
Yeah, I don't understand that.
Okay. Now you signed a big sponsorship deal with Pepsi recently, and your celebration is to pass out warm Pepsis. Is that right?
It is. I mean, okay. Look, to be honest, it's partly a contractual obligation that I have to talk about it a lot. But yeah, Pepsi is one of our sponsors. A hot cup of Pepsi doesn't go amiss, as we say. We need to warm it up hot. We have it every half time, as hot as we can.
Right.
And we've also got another. We've got two sponsors on our shirt. First club in history to have two next to each other. We've got Bongella. Bongella, which is it's a tube. It's a blue tube of stuff. You pop it in your mouth and you feel great.
Yeah.
Do you encourage people to use Bongella even when they don't have a mouth ulcer? Is that
Absolutely. I mean, look, because I had a mouth ulcer. Bongella said, look, you just got to keep having it. Just keep having it. Right. And I've been on it for about 4 years.
Okay. Oh, right. Okay. Okay. How do you warm the Pepsi up? Is it in an urn, or do you have it in a kettle, or how do you do it? In a pan?
Yeah, that's a very good question. Look, some people prefer a pan. I pop it in a slow cooker for about 8 hours every morning.
Okay.
But you need to really get it to 200 degrees. It needs to be boiling. It needs to be full fat Pepsi, because then the sugar, the fat floats to the top.
Does it retain its effervescence?
Of course.
Oh, good.
And I suppose if you're running around for as fast as you can for as long as you can, that helps.
Of course it does. I mean, look, there's been a lot of the... And look, I think you lads seem all right, but I've had a lot of the fake news press attacking me a lot of the time. A lot of them talking about tooth decay in the club, and our club doctors have checked it out. There's absolutely no link between the hot Pepsi every half-time and the tooth decay.
Okay.
Where do you think the tooth decay... I hate to ask these difficult questions. It's what I'm paid to do. Where do you think the tooth decay is coming from?
Cigarettes, probably.
Okay.
Okay.
Great. When's the next game, Bilal?
Next game will be Monday at 9:30 p.m. broadcast, twitch.tv/staffercakes. Oh, we're in Europe again. We're playing in Europe, I think. Some sort of foreign team, I'm not sure.
Okay, great stuff.
Well, listen, thanks. Good luck with the game, and let us know how you get on.
Thanks so much, lads. All the best, yeah?
Good. Bilal Zafar, manager of PES United. And as you say, you can watch it on twitch.tv.
Zafar Cakes.
That's it, Zafar Cakes. Excellent. Yeah. Sound like they're doing pretty well.
So he sounds in control of his team, mm-hmm. and in charge, and to have some interesting training methods. A bit like when Wenger came in and stopped all the players going out and getting drunk every afternoon.
The you hot know, Pepsi is the next, hot Pepsi is the could next be the, step.
The next on that, step, isn't it?
I was listening to the interview with the Warren Pepsi guy, and I thought, this is the worst radio I have ever heard.
Oh, okay.
And then I realised, oh God, I'm on next.
and it's really slumped since you came on, Barry.
I mean, what was that?
Barry!
I literally had no idea what he was talking about.
He's the manager of PES...
Feet Hot Pepsi at half-time.
PESC FC.
You've got to learn about these things, Barry.
Pro Evolution Soccer.
It's a bit...